Only you can be responsible for the content you put into your written works. This is what makes you unique and your written works exclusive to you alone. But what about its presentation? You can't judge a book by its cover, right? Well, actually, most people do just that, and this is why so much time is spent putting an attractive cover on even your 10-page document. Fortunately, MS Word makes this super easy and fast. We start by looking at the script file I prepared for this video's production. I have the template to show the slide number, image, and narrator text. With the document open on the screen, I navigate to the Insert ribbon. On the far left bar, select Cover Page. Scroll through the list and select one of the ready-made images for the one you want. You pick one and it is applied to the top of your document. It automatically sets the section break settings to make the cover page without a page number applied. It is also taken out of the series for continuous numbering. Throughout this series, I will be using a habitat analysis document to set the example. I open a Word document I prepared in 2013 with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service to analyze specific lamprey habitat in Assotin Creek, located in Assotin County, Washington. You can see the PDF version of this document by accessing the resource-analysis.com website, navigating to the Resource Analysis heading and the Habitat Analysis subheading. You know you have found the right place when you see the lamprey smile photograph. In this section, you will find the PDF so you can see the image settings applied through MS Word. Generally, in a professional document, you will have a cover page, a title page, followed by your table of contents, list of figures, list of tables, list of equations, and even your acronyms used. These are all numbered as III III. When your content actually begins, that is where the page numbering restarts from 1, 2, 3. Within this document, you can see how settings are placed in a footer with opposing page numbers on the left and right side pages. This is set in the Insert ribbon at the Header and Footer settings. Select Header and Footer settings separately. Experiment with the settings and apply them to the document as you wish. The only way to really get comfortable with these settings is to experiment with them. Try it out, find out which settings you want, and then make them part of your document. You will see tables inserted into this document. One of the soon-to-come videos in this series tells more about how to create tables with headings made part of your style sheet settings. Their pagination is super important to follow in your document. So, make sure to keep watching these videos to learn really how to make it happen. In this document, I made all the analysis images in Esri ArcGIS, then exported them as PNG files. The PNG files are inserted into Word in the figure headings created as a style sheet. They are all arranged with landscape orientation. The pages match the images. That is one of those section break settings to make it different from the portrait orientation you find in the layout ribbon. All of these figures were introduced and discussed in the document with figure number references for the reader. A few of the largest tables are inserted in this section as well. Again, they were all referenced in the main document first. The last content is the Works Cited section, in this case in the APA format. The last page of the document has a statement of this effect and an example citation for readers to use when they cite this document. Now we step into MS Word to look at the settings of this document. As we scroll through it, you will see the title page, cover page, and some blanked out headings for the table of contents, list of figures, list of tables, and acronyms used. These are all part of the document, but I have removed them for this demonstration. I want you to look at the page number seen on the lists section. It shows page III. This is where I want you to become familiar with the paragraph icon seen in the home ribbon. Click this little icon and the non-printing characters will appear on your screen. These do not print and it confuses the pagination of your document while it is turned on. You quickly see some of the characters added to the text, making it difficult to read. I use these settings when formatting my documents, not generally when composing them. When we get to the bottom of the page, with the abstract, page number is 4. That is because the page numbering setting, which continued the numbering from the list pages, where they were III and III. Page 4 is the next one in order, so it was used. Look through the document to see horizontal lines for section break and page break. Page numbering can be restarted at the section break next page, but not section break continuous. One last look at the bottom of page III shows its page number. Place your cursor on the page with abstract selected. Navigate to the Insert ribbon, then to the Header and Footer tab. Click the Page Number icon and select Format Page Numbers setting. This is where you set the number format and whether to continue from previous page or start at 1. You select OK, and it is applied. In this video series, we explore how to apply the style sheets within your documents as you give it structure. You have seen in video 1 about the usefulness of this structure, and in this video, how to set page numbers and to create a cover page. Next up, we will explore how to manage and apply style sheets within your documents. Yeah, we are doing it now. This is where you make it happen.